So, the root cause problem elimination. It's really a structured approach to eliminate problems. That's all it is. What usually happens when people say they're the root cause, in my experience, is this. It's a morning meeting, and someone says, motor tripped out, causing a production loss. So what happens in that morning meeting, now I haven't been to yours, but somewhere, the first thing people say is, it a maintenance problem, or is this an operations problem? Oh, it's a motor that tripped out, so this is obviously a maintenance problem. So operations guys, they say, oh, they just lean back and they stop thinking now. So, oh, great, we don't have to worry about this, it's not our problem. So you lose 75% of your thinking power. So the maintenance department continues to say, okay, is this a maintenance problem? No, is this a mechanical problem, or is this an E&I problem? And they're going to say, no, it's not mechanical, it's a motor that tripped. Of course, that very homogeneous group of E&I, we need to figure out if it's electrical or instrumentation. Electrical instrumentation, well, it's a motor that tripped, so obviously it's an electrical problem. Now, this goes into a corporate report that says we have so many downtime, hours of downtime of electrical equipment, or the electrical department has this many hours of downtime. So these 4 hours goes now to the electrical problem, right? What we're asking here is whose fault it is. We're breaking the first rule of any root cause problem elimination, root cause failure analysis, problem solving method that's ever existed since the beginning of times by doing this report. We're asking whose fault it is, and now we solve the problem, right? Driving wedges between departments, that's all we're doing, trying to do. Now, when I ask people, what are you going to use, people in general, in plants, what are you going to use this data for? Because what happened is, in the end of the day, at some point, I didn't have that example there, sorry. At some point, we have a production report saying that, okay, we have this many hours of downtime for electrical, we have this many hours of downtime for mechanical, this many for operations, etc., right? So this for maintenance. What are we going to use that data for? I never really had an answer for that, what that data is used for. We need to report it to corporate. That's it. Yeah, that's all it does, right?
We actually go through it with the crews. Anytime there's one done, and we do one, we encounter 3 hours plus downtime.
But that's when you actually do root cause, which is good. But what I'm saying is, if you just collect this data and you say, now, the mechanical department has 500 hours of downtime, that number is not really helping you for what to do. So you're not going to get more people just because you have a lot of downtime. You know that. That's what I'm saying.